seen the mess sewage spills cause. You've heard about the constant beach closures. And Monday night, members of the public got to hear exactly what the Environmental Protection Agency is doing to help mitigate the ongoing problem.
It was interesting to us because we live here in California. We care about the bay, we care about the ocean, and we also care about Imperial Beach because we go down there a lot and actually have property down there.
At the informational meeting organized by local nonprofit Citizens Oversight, an EPA environmental engineer shared about the history of Tijuana's current water infrastructure and the ways Mexico is working with the U.S. on the issue.
We just received a letter of commitment from Mexico, from the Federal Water Commission in Mexico, saying they want to apply this coming year 35 million gallons specifically to address the Tijuana wastewater issues. That's a huge amount for Mexico.
The EPA has funded a number of studies to look for solutions to transboundary pollution in both Mexico and the U.S., and that work will continue. There's been annual funding dedicated to border water infrastructure since 1996, and the hope is that funding will also continue.
Clearly, there's a large group of people working on it, just putting brain power into it, and we hope that they're going to come up with some good solutions. I think the bottom line is, though, money needs to come in from someplace to help get the fixes in place.